Good evening, everyone. Welcome to my channel. My name is Judah. I'm a Nigerian international medical graduate. I wrote my step 2 in December of 2024. So in this video, I want to tell you how I studied to get a score of 266. All right, without further ado, let's just get started. So the first thing I used was Uworld. So I went through Uworld in random mode. I went through the whole of Uworld in random mode. It took a while because I was combining studies with work. It took about 3 months, give or take. I went through the whole of Uworld random mode. Okay. So when I was done with that, I took my first MBME. Then after that, I entered into the CMS forms. CMS forms I will call clinical mastery forms. Okay. So there are a set of 50 questions each in the different disciplines tested on the step 2. For example, internal medicine, surgery, pediatrics, psychiatry, and the rest. Okay. So each form has 50 questions. Most of the forms have 8 forms. For instance, internal medicine has forms 1 to 8, each containing 50 questions. Some of the more recent forms, like emergency medicine, also has 3 forms. From, as I think of recording this video, to the best of my knowledge, forms 1 to 3. Okay, so I did those forms. I didn't finish it. I didn't complete that. Due to time constraints, I was only able to complete around 3 to 4 CMS forms per discipline. So that was that. And after that, I took another MBME to really check my progress. Then I settled on AMBOS. Now, it's recommended generally that you do as many questions as you can by preparing for step 2. So that was what guided my prep. They drive to do so a lot of questions. So some people can decide to do Uworld twice, some even 3 times. Okay, but for me, I decided to do a pass of Uworld and a pass of AMBOS because I didn't want that bias of, you know, seeing questions I've already seen before, then trying to guess the answer based on what it was before. I just didn't want that. Even though it has worked for a lot of people that really did well, most scored higher than 266. You know, but for me, I felt it would be better if I see a fresh set of questions. So I went into AMBOS. Okay, so I also went through, well, I didn't finish AMBOS because I already booked my exam and time was running short at that moment. So I was able to do about 95% of AMBOS. And after that, I fully focused on the remaining MBMEs. Of course, for the step 2, in case you don't know what MBME means, MBME stands for National Board of Medical Examiners, and the group of people that set the USMLE exam, all right? So they have a kind of mock tests, each containing 200 questions that test the concept tested on the USMLE Step 2 CK. So we have the MBME forms, as I have recorded this video, to the best of my knowledge, at MBME is 9 to 15 for Step 2. You know, sorry, actually MBME is 6 to 15. However, 6 to 8 are considered as the older MBMEs, while 9 to 15 are considered the newer MBMEs, okay? So if you have time, go for it. Like I said, the more questions you do, preparing for step 2 CK, the better eventual outcome, all right? But if you have very short on time, you can just do the newer one, which is 9 to 15. That's what I did. I did the newer MBMs, MBMs 9 to 15. So like I said, I did MBME 9 after Uworld. I did MBME 10 after the CMS forms. So I still had about 5 MBMs left. So I then continued doing the MBMs up until my exam. Okay, I did mention something. I also did what we call AMBOS High Yield. There's a segment of AMBOS. While I did the general AMBOS Step 2 question bank, there's a segment of AMBOS that has concepts that are said to be high yield concepts that are tested on every Step 2 exam. There's a 200 high yield concept, and there are also some segments that are also high yield, like vaccination, screening, risk factors, and the like, ethics, patient safety. So I did those specifically. Now, while someone doing AMBOS may actually do those questions while doing the review. By the way, I didn't mention that. I did my AMBOS by system. So I did Uworld random, I did AMBOS system. So I'll advise you, in your first pass, actually, I did it in the reverse, but I'll advise that in your first pass of the question bank, do it system mode. So you focus your learning in a system manner. You learn a lot of things about that system together, and you keep on learning about systems. Then your second pass, then you now do it in random mode so that you can test on everything simultaneously, just like how the exam will be like, but I reversed it. But still, I had my MBMs to test it in a random fashion, so that still worked out fine. All right, so I did my AMBOS in system mode. But those highest concepts, those ethics, vaccination, screening, while you say encounter them while they live in Ambon. Generally, it's best to do it in the high yield because you have a full picture, you have a complete picture of the whole thing. For instance, there's a screenings. There are a lot of different screening at different age. When you do the screening questions all together, you have a picture of the different screening for the different group of people at different age. Same thing in vaccination. When you do all the vaccination questions together, you paint a picture in your mind of when you do the, take different vaccines. When you take the influenza vaccine, when you take the rotavirus vaccine, when you take different kind of the HPV vaccine. So you have a timeline, a male, a female, what is the timeline for vaccines based on the age? So it kind of consolidates the whole picture. So yeah, I also did the AMBOS high section. So I've mentioned Uworld, CMS forms, AMBOS generally, then AMBOS high section, and the MBME forms. So those were the foundation of my prep. Now there's some other resources I also made use of. There's the Divine Intervention podcast. I didn't go through the whole of the Divine Intervention podcast. There are some episodes where people that have done well on the step 2 exam highlighted and they recommended those particular episodes. They said they feel those episodes are the highest yield. And that's what I did. I just went through those episodes. So on the screen are the episodes I did that helped me. You can consider doing everything, but those are the episodes I did. Okay. Then also for some difficult topics, I also made use of pathoma pathology, for the pathology aspect, infectious disease, sketchy micro. Occasionally, I refer to AJ Monix, Ninja Net, and all those other things. But these resources I've mentioned were my primary focus. My primary focus in prep for the step 2 CK was questions. I didn't go through first aid or any PDF resource. I actually tried going through a PDF resource. I wasn't really enjoying the experience, so I just left it out. Okay, the one I tried going through was Mailman. By the way, I prepared Mailman to first aid. I just felt I'll gain better value for my time just doing questions, and that's what I did. So a part of Uworld, the most recent CMS forms, a part of AMBOS, AMBOS high yield section, the MBM is 9 to 15. Those were the cornerstone of my preparation, and I had the 266. Alright, so I'll be releasing more videos about specifics, how I use it, more specifics also how I use the Uworld, how to use the AMBOS, how to use the MBME, the CMS in the future. So if you like content like this, do subscribe and also like this video so you get more notifications. So if you have any specific requests you want me to make a video about, you can drop it in the comments. I'll attend to it. Thank you. See you in the next one.